Alrighty then, my dudes. Let's now go and look for Robert de Sable. So apparently there might be... The funeral was a trap. Robert de Sable was not there. There was a woman over there, but Robert, however, was not. So... Okay. Anyways. Just scratched my mic for a moment there. Anyways. Let's now go and hunt him down. So, we must now travel over to Arsuf, where he is going to convince the likes of both King Richard and Salah al-Din that the assassins are the enemy. And of course, if that happens, then well... We will basically be dead, so we have to stop Robert de Sable. From telling both of those men about our ill intentions. And so, I must head over here.
You have no business here.
And so, I shall now... Oh, I'm not heading in the right direction. Anyways. I shall head over here. Is that where I need to head? Okay. Well, I've got a couple of turns I need to make first, but... I think I have an idea of what it is I need to do. And I need to try and see if I can reach the exit. Which I don't think is too far from here. Again, I'm not heading in the right direction. I have no idea where I'm going at the moment. But whichever direction I'm heading in, it's clearly not the correct direction. The way I currently see it, I am clearly following my directions incorrectly. But I think I know where it is I need to be. And I shall now... head over here, so it does mean I am now getting closer to the exit. Just depends on knowing if I can manage to, you know,
why would he do that?
Find this exit. So... Oh, right. I am only meters away from the exit. Apparently at the moment things are not going well. But I think I know where the exit is. It's just a matter of knowing if I can reach it or not. That's the main question. Oh shit. That's not the way I was wanting to do it. Well, anyways. I now need to get on my horse. Come on, get the hell out of here. Come on, run away! Running away from the guards! And how will we get to Arsuf in the shortest possible time? Well, if I just head over to Acre, or Arca, whichever one you think is more appropriate.
Some of your pursuers will make it easier to escape.
So if I head over to Acre, I can basically head over to the part of the kingdom which leads to Acre, and then once I have done that, we will basically be on the road closest to Arsuf. So basically I need to head over here, and then I can head over to Arsuf, because this is the city that is closest to Arsuf. So now I shall head in the other direction. Oh, okay. Anyways, I'm now gonna head over to the kingdom, which should lead me over to Arsuf. So if I can head over here, then I should be able to make it to Arsuf. That took a much slower amount of time than I thought it was gonna take. Anyways, let's now head over to Arsuf. So we cannot take the shortest route, no doubt in saying Robert has probably already taken that route, and so I shall need to take the other route, even though I will be disturbing a guard march whilst I do it. But anyways, this is where we must head to make it to Arsuf. So we must head over here. And we are going to be dealing with a bunch of guards, a bunch of Saracen guards, to make it all the way over.
When you're out of knives, refill your stock by returning to Masayev, or by pickpocketing thugs.
Okay, anyways. Let's now take down some guards, since I know they are inevitably going to be here. Oh, okay. Okay, never mind. I thought for sure I could do something, but apparently I cannot. Okay, well, anyways. So that is basically the Saracen army down there. And we are going to have to deal with a bunch of guards before we take down Robert. So, all I have to do now is kill these archers, since I would imagine they are well trained. This is probably going to be quite a task. Okay. Well, that's all of the archers taken care of, so let's now head over here, where we will now be after our next target. You are not knocking me off here. Not today. Would you care to say that again? Or would you prefer to just do the... Or would you just prefer to do the proper thing and fight? Oh, someone shot me. Someone definitely shot me there. Oh, yep. That's exactly how I wanted to do this. Except for saying it clearly wasn't. Oh, there he is. Alright, you fucker. Time for you to die. Okay. Well, anyways. Let's now go and find out where Robert is. And of course, there is going to be a lot of in-game dialogue we need to voice here, so it's not going to be easy for me to kill all of these, but I know very well that most of the time I have managed to either kill or flee from the Saracen guards. So now I must take care of all of these, and they are now all dead. So let's now get some more guards whilst we are here. Ok, because I do not want to go through this whole game again once I am done. Okay. Just had to check my PC to see if it was still doing it, but anyways. Let's now go and reach repair. Although, first of all, we have some guards to take care of. Well, at least I can say he gave me more room. He gave me more fighting room, at the very least. Oh, shit. There we go. Okay. So, still have a couple more to take care of, but I know very well I'm going to have to kill all of these. So, getting closer at least. Oh, I could not use the grab break. He was ready for that one. He was ready for that. Come on. Come on. Almost there. Come on. I'm getting there. Come on. Come on. Come on. Please kill him. Please kill him. Okay, that's all of them. Let's now head over here and confront Robert de Sable. I'm also going to mute myself whilst I'm here because, well, in-game dialogue.
You can't get away from me!
Okay, we have now cleared the Templars, so let's now go after Robert de Sable, since we have cleared both the Saracen and Templar guards. Anyways, in-game dialogue time.
Come no further.
Hold a moment. It's words I bring, not steel.
Offering terms of surrender then. It's about time.
You misunderstand. It's Al-Muallim who sends me, not Salah-Al-Din.
Assassin! What is the meaning of this? And be quick with it!
You've a traitor in your midst.
And he has hired you to kill me? Come to gloat about it before you strike? I wouldn't be taken so easily!
It's not you I've come to kill. It's him.
Speak then, that I may judge the truth. Who is this traitor?
Robert de Sable.
My lieutenant!
He aims to betray.
That's not the way he tells it. He seeks revenge against your people for the havoc you've wrought in Arc. And I am inclined to support him. Some of my best men were murdered by some of yours.
It was I who killed them, and for good reason. Hear me out. William of Montferrat. He sought to use his soldiers to take Aqqa by force. Gagné d'Enaplus. He would use his skills to indoctrinate and control any who resisted. Sabran, he intended to block the ports, preventing your kingdom from providing aid. They betrayed you, and they took their orders from Robert.
You expect me to believe this outlandish tale?
You knew these men better than I. Are you truly surprised to learn of their ill intentions?
Is this true?
My liege, it is an assassin that stands before us. These creatures are masters of manipulation. Of course it isn't true.
I've no reason to deceive.
Oh, but you do. You're afraid of what will happen to your little fortress. Can it withstand the combined might of the Saracen and the Crusader army?
My concern is for the people of the Holy Land. If I must sacrifice myself for there to be peace, so be it.
This is a strange place we find ourselves in. Each of you accusing the other.
There really is no time for this. I must be off to meet with Saladin and enlist his aid. The longer we delay, the harder this will become.
Hold a moment, Robert.
Why? What do you intend? Surely you do not believe him.
It is a difficult decision, one I cannot make alone. I must leave it in the hands of one wiser than I.
Thank you.
No, Robert, not you.
Then who?
The Lord. Let this be decided by combat. Surely God will side with the one whose cause is righteous.
If this is what you wish.
It is.
So be it. To arms, assassin! Ma colère est mortelle! Je vais t'étriper!
Tu veux mourir? Tu veux mourir?
Come on. Almost there. Come on, take him down. Okay, let's take him down. Let's take down Robert now. Let's take him down. Since I know he will no doubt be the toughest. Since I have no doubt in my mind in saying he will probably be the toughest of all the men we've had to kill. Okay. I need to be away from there. Even though he may have an intention of killing me first. Okay.
It's done then. Your schemes, like you, are put to rest.
You know nothing of schemes. You're but a puppet. He betrayed you, boy. Just as he betrayed me.
Speak sense, Templar. Or not at all.
9 men he sent you to kill, yes? The 9 who guarded the treasure's secret.
What of it?
It wasn't 9 who found the treasure, assassin. Not 9, but 10.
A 10th? None may live who carry the secret. Give me his name.
Oh, but you know him well. And I doubt very much you'd take his life as willingly as you've taken mine.
Who?
It is your master, Al-Mualim.
But he is not a Templar.
Did you never wonder how it is he knew so much? Where to find us, how many we numbered, what we aspired to attain?
He is the master of the assassins.
Oui, master of lies. You and I just 2 more pawns in his grand game. And now, with my death, only you remain. Do you think he'll let you live, knowing what you do?
I've no interest in the treasure.
Ah, but he does.
The only difference between your master and I is that he did not want to share.
No.
Ironic, isn't it? That I, your greatest enemy, kept you safe from harm. But now you've taken my life, and in the process, ended your own.
Well fought, assassin. It seems God favors your cause this day.
God had nothing to do with it. I was the better fighter.
Ah, you may not believe in him, but it seems he believes in you. Before you go, I have a question.
Ask it then.
Why? Why travel all this way? Risk your life a thousand times, all to kill a single man.
He threatened my brothers and what we stand for.
Ah, vengeance then.
No, not vengeance. Justice, that there might be peace.
This is what you fight for? Peace? Do you see the contradiction?
Some men cannot be reasoned with.
Like that madman, Saladin.
I think he'd like to see an end to this war as much as you.
So I've heard, but never seen.
Even if he doesn't say it, it's what the people want. Saracen and Crusader alike.
The people know not what they want. It's why they turn to men like us.
Then it falls to men like you to do what is right.
Nonsense. We come into the world kicking and screaming, violent and unstable. It is what we are. We cannot help ourselves.
No. We are what we choose to be.
Your kind. Always playing with words.
I speak the truth. There's no trick to be found here.
We'll know soon enough. But I fear you cannot have what you desire this day. Even now, that heathen Saladin cuts through my men and I must attend to them. But perhaps, having seen how vulnerable he is, he will reconsider his actions. Yes. In time, what you seek may be possible.
You were no more secure than him. Do not forget that. The men you left behind to rule in your stead did not intend to serve you for longer than they had.
Yes. Yes. I am well aware.
Then I'll take my leave. My master and I have much to discuss. It seems that even he is not without fault.
He is only human, as are we all. You as well.
Safety and peace be upon you.
Al-Mualim is the 10th Templar? This cannot be. All these years, I've looked to him for strength and guidance. His word has always been truth, and now I am told it's all been a lie? No. Even in death, Robert seeks to poison my mind. Or does he? I remember the careful way in which the Master avoided my questions, changed the subject when I dug too deep. It was indifference. He sought to teach me. Or blind obedience? Willful ignorance of the truth. There is but only one way to answer these questions. I must seek Al-Mualim. And of course, before we do that, I need to get a thumbnail shot. Since we have now finished our conversation with Richard. By the way, this is of course King Richard I, also known as Richard the Lionheart, if you've studied the Middle Ages like I have in high school education. But yeah, anyways. Let's now resume our session and go back to the lab. And I will also mute myself, since memory block 6 is now complete. Let's now head over to the cutscene in the Abstergo, muting myself once again for this next cutscene.
I said get up, goddammit! Listen!
Oh no.
Seems your assassin friends found us.
What?
How'd you do it, Desmond?
Hey, look, I don't know what you're talking about, but whatever's going on down there has got nothing to do with me.
They're here for you, and I sure as shit didn't invite them. What's the situation down there?
We're taking heavy fire.
Can you contain it, or do I need to evacuate the prisoner?
Only five or six. We've got them outnumbered. A couple of wounded, but we'll pull through. We'll get it under control.
God damn you, Desmond. You couldn't leave well enough alone.
I told you I had nothing to do with this. How would I even contact them? Telepathy? Come on!
Doesn't matter. They'll be dead soon enough. Here, have a listen.
That's been neutralized.
Looks like the cavalry won't be coming.
Dunno, Doc. We're freaking out a minute ago. Your little research facility not as secure as you thought it was? Worried they'll be back with more?
I don't think so, Desmond.
What Lucy here is trying to say is that there aren't any assassins left to come for you. We've been very busy this past year, hunting down your little enclaves, your desert communes and whatnot. I'm afraid you're on your own. Rest up, Mr. Miles. Tomorrow, we finish this.
I'm sorry, Desmond.
You mentioned the desert. Do you think...
They sent a team there, but the place was deserted. I don't know where your parents are, and I can't promise they're still alive. But I think they got away.
Thanks. Thanks for checking.
It's not as bad as it seems.
What are you talking about? They just killed, literally killed, my only chance of getting out of here. And then I find out the assassins are all but destroyed, and Christ, I still don't know what these people are planning. But I do know they plan to kill me when they're done. I am screwed, okay? What do you want me to do?
Just try and have a little faith.
You're...
Have faith. Rest up, Desmond. You're gonna need the energy.
Okay. So, now that that's all done, and Lucy is walking away from the premises, although just in case, I will need to try and see if she has anything else to give us. But yeah, I'll just check to be sure.
Aren't you tired?
Okay, so apparently she is not going to be revealing anything else to us. But anyways... We have just one memory block remaining, and so now that the door has been locked, we can just decode it and have a look at some of the emails. Although I'm not going to read them aloud because, well, quite frankly, I don't care. But I will have a look and see what new messages there are because, well, I'm cheeky like that. So, let's have a look at the deleted items first. This looks like it might be one of those... Yeah. Yes. Okay. Oh, that's interesting. Anyways. Let's now have a look at the... inbox. Since I'm just randomly scrolling through each of these emails. And I do wonder... Is there anything in the inbox? No, there isn't. Okay. Well... I think I'm just gonna head up here for a moment and see what there is. For me to locate, just to see what there is on Warren's laptop, just to see if there's anything important. And yeah. Again, I'm not reading these aloud, but if you really want to, you can basically read them at your own leisure. Just because I want to look through and see what else there is. And apparently we also get a message from someone called Alan Rickon. And already read this. So, however, there is one more part of the lab we can access now that we are into memory block number 6. And I think there is a decoder here somewhere, and yes, there is. So, if I decode this, we can get into the lab. And there is another computer around here somewhere, which we can also access. Another laptop, by the way, because, well, no one's watching us. So, if I log in here, welcome Project Lead 9. And we have just one email we can read. And apparently, they are looking for something called the Piece of Eden. Sorry about that. Again, I'm still a sick boy who is suffering from hay fever. That was precisely what caused that very disturbing cough, and somehow the tickle is still there, so I have a feeling it's gonna happen again at some point, but anyways. Just randomly going through the email, since I cannot really be bothered to read it. And now, I must head back to bed, because that is where I will head. So, obviously not going to tell about the emails or read them aloud, because, well, instead, I'm just going to end off the segment here. So, it's time to finish this. Next time, we will be doing the final memory block. Stay tuned for the finale.